All right, here we go with the beach house again. We did a living room and a dining room. So now let's do the bedroom. Okay, so if we're gonna do a bedroom, we gotta make a bed, right? So there's a lot of parts and pieces in this whole bedroom overall, especially the bed, but we're gonna gather it all together as much as we can, and we're just gonna make a bed frame. Easy enough, it's just a box, missing one side. The only tricky part is to realize that the sides, they do go in just a smidge. You'll see that there's a gap at the on the right side there. So just line it up all the way to the bottom. And why do we put that gap there? So that we can fit this piece in. So if you do it all right, it should line up nicely all the way around. Or you could do this piece first and then the sides, either way. While that's drying, we're gonna make the headboard, and it can't be any easier. Basically, we're going to glue these two fancy dowels on each side and then a decoration in the middle. When I'm making these pieces, I'm just basically setting them aside to dry as much as possible before moving on to the next step. So while all those pieces are drying, I'm going to make the bedspread. And what I did is, there's kind of a pattern on this. So I wanted that line to go down the middle. So I just lined it up, the pattern, kind of in the middle of your little pattern square. Normally, I would go all the way to the edge of the material so as not to waste, but this one, I definitely wanted the pattern to be right. Once you got your little quilt piece of material cut out the way you want it, so I got the nice equal little squares there, you're just gonna fold it over and glue it. I tried holding it down with just my fingers, holding it down for a while. It didn't really stick very nicely, so I did end up just clipping it with my little mini clothespins. And we gotta make our bed nice and squishy, so we're just gonna cut this piece. This is the batting, and it's gonna go underneath our quilt. And we're gonna wrap that all the way around. So just cut it to the pattern, and we'll go on to building the bed. Our pieces are nice and dry, so we can work with it so it doesn't collapse on us. And we're just gonna put the headboard right on, and it should fit right in there. first up, we're going to put our little batting on it. When I glued it all the way around, I noticed the corners didn't glue down. I probably could have left them because the quilt kind of floofs up there, but I wanted to stay consistent and just glue down the corners. This I could hold down with my fingers. It only took a few seconds for it to tack down. Next, we're going to put our quilt on. Now, you don't want to glue it all the way to the top like this, because what's going to happen is it's not going to go all the way to the bottom. So what you're going to want to do is glue from the bottom up so that it lays flat, or even, I should say, and it covers all the sides. The little gap at the top, it will be covered with little pillows. Speaking of pillows, let's make a few. This is probably my least favorite any kit is to make these little tiny pillows. For some reason, they just, it's not an enjoyable project for me. You know, some kits like it to be sewn, some like it to be glued. This particular one, they want it to be glued. So I'm just going to use the brown material. Make sure you put your pattern on the wrong side, so the non-floofy side. And just, you're gonna make three of this dark brown and two of the yellow pillows. Once all your pieces are cut out, you're just going to glue these in half and make sure you leave a little opening at the top. So kind of like a little pita pocket. I don't know if I mentioned this before, but get yourself a bag of these little mini clips. Go to the dollar store right now, get a bag of 100. They are so useful, and I use them all the time. And when I break them, I just go get another bag. They're super cheap. But once this is all glued and dried, we're just gonna open it up, and we're gonna stuff it with a little bit of this little stuffing. I just used the back end of my tweezers and jammed it in there. This worked great on this heavier material. It was a little bit harder on the lighter material because it didn't want to open up. So it was a lot of trial and error and pushing it in, but eventually I did get it in there. And you're just going to glue the end up. Now, some of the batting is going to come out a little bit. It's okay. We're going to close it up with our clothespins. Let it dry completely. When you take your clothespins off, you can then trim off all that fuzzy. And see, there we go. And if they do pucker on the side, you could leave it and just make sure that side's on the side that doesn't show on your project. Or, like I did, I just went through and just sealed them up. Little raviolis. on the bed, they left a little hat and a little dress. So we're going to make the hat. I tried gluing this down. So it's basically a piece of cardboard cut to the template and then this little rivet button in the middle. And then you're supposed to glue this material over the top. Easier said than done. I did it once and then for some reason it just came right off. So I'm gluing it again. And the first time I only tried to do it with my fingers. This time we are going to use our handy little clothespins. I don't know why I wavered from using it before. And just use a whole bunch. This little button piece in the middle, I mean, in the pictures it shows it pops up a lot more than it shows. Doesn't really, and so you kind of have to squish it and manipulate it until it looks like a little hat. Ta-da! Nothing else, you made a cool ornament of a sort. Once that's completely dry, now I'm going to cut the edges. I didn't want to cut it to exact size the first time around because I knew this was going to move around on us. So, it's hat-like, right? And now we're going to put the little band. Now, this is what I mean. It doesn't stick up in the middle enough for you to just tie it on. It's just kind of a little lump. So what I decided to do is I'm going to make a loop the size of the hat band approximately, and I'm just going to tie it off this way. I will say the trick to tying tiny bows is to keep your strings long. So make a big bow and then you're just going to pull your little strings until it's a smaller bow and then you trim it. So you're going to make a bigger bow than you want it and then just pull it until it's the size you actually want it. That's the easiest way I found. Now we got our hat band with the little bow on it, and this was kind of a pain to get on here. So we're going to go back to our handy dandy little clothespins. We could have just glued it just like that and give the illusion of a hat band, but I wanted it to be a slightly more realistic. So I just put a bunch of glue and then forced it down with the clothespins and let this completely dry. And once it's all dry and we know it's not going to fall off, there we go. Hey, not too shabby. And now we're going to make a cute little strappy dress. So what we want to do is cut this lace. It's 5 centimeters. We're going to fold it in half and all sorts. So just cut that to size. And then you're going to cut the blue ribbons, or the straps of the dress, to 3 centimeters. And you need 2 of them. And what we're going to do is we're just going to kind of approximately put the straps where it looks right to you. It doesn't really say where to exactly put them. And you're going to loop them around. And what I did is I did the straps first, pinned it, let it dry, and then I folded it in half. When I folded this dress around, I wanted the straps to look reasonable to where it should go, so I kind of centered it up. It ended up that I had to fold it over just a smidge more for it to be centered correctly, which is fine, and then just glued it and pinned it and let it set to dry. Once you got it all dry, ta-da, cute little ruffly dress. And then we're just gonna place our pillows and all of our accessories. Go. Super cute. Okay, next up, we gotta make a little bedside table for our bed. And we've done this furniture a million times before. Just follow the directions. So what I did is I made 2 of these little posts. So there's a middle slat and then 2 legs. So I made 2 of those. And then just tried to keep it as flat as I could. I use the back of my ruler to kind of flatten it out. And for some reason it wants to focus on my finger and not the, there we go. Now you want those to dry a little bit, because once you tip it up like this, you don't want them to fall apart. And all you should have left to do is just to put the little middle pieces on the top and the bottom. And just square it up as best as you can. I think the key to, I guess, any project is let it dry as much as you can before going to the next step. Like if I hadn't let this dry and did this, this would have fell all to pieces. Just glue it to the top. I do it upside down so that I can get it as flush as possible, and then just center it up. Ta-da! And now we're gonna make a little handle and just cut it to size. And then you're gonna bend it on each end. I'm gonna use my pliers here. If you use the same spot on your pliers each time, it'll be relatively even. And you just got a little baby staple looking thing. going to glue it on our table. You could glue it like this, but it's going to fall down just like that. So your best bet is to lay it like this and then tip it up. Got a little table. We'll set that aside and we're gonna make some stuff to go on it, like a cute little lighthouse lamp. Now, we made a lighthouse in the last video. It's basically the same thing, so we're just gonna make a couple of tubes and stick them together. So there's a big kind of a cone shape, and that's going to be the lampshade, and then there's a smaller cone for the base of it. Once we got all our pieces, we're gonna glue our base, the top part of it, onto this circle. This is going to be what holds the lampshade in the right spot. So just kind of get it in the middle as best you can, just like that. And then we're gonna put the lampshade right on top of that. I let this dry completely upside down and just made sure it was as upright as possible, and then just once it's dry we can set it onto our table. Ta-da! And a little book. We've made a bunch of books before. It's the same thing. This one's got one. There's a few books here and there. You just make them all and then you're gonna set them here and there. And then this little cute elephant. I think it's a piggy bank. All right, another chair. This one's an orange, let me see if I say it right, a poolside chair. It's a cute little chair. So the only tricky part on this one is these funky side pieces. So it takes a second to realize which way this goes. So it's gonna go like that. So where my fingers are on the left side is the front. All right, so this chair has a little lean to it. If you've ever been in one of these chairs, we have a couple on our porch. So the back side is going to go on the part that goes in the back that kind of leans back a little bit. So if you got it all mixed up, you know the straight goes right in the front and then the lean goes in the back. And then you're gonna have three little slats and then a long one. So you'll know these three, the shorter slats, if you don't use your chart, go on where the seat is. So I just kind of lined up the back one with the back of the chair. And then I did the front one and then I stuck the middle in just to kind of try to space it out properly. Once you got those relatively where you want them, and they do tend to want to flop over, then you're going to put the other side of the chair on there. I And if you got it all right, it should sit upright. Ta-da! Now remember, we had that longer piece, so that's going to go right here in the front. It's going to be right here where the front of the seat is. And then we're going to put the armrests on. My dad's made a few of these chairs. They're very comfy. They don't look like they are, but they are very comfy. Let that dry a little bit, but first let's stick one of our, because remember we made three of these, we're gonna put one of the pillows right there. This room also has a funky little wall decoration. It's supposed to be like a fishing net. So I would say the only tricky part on this one is cutting out your little triangle. So what I did is I went with the material. So you'll see the material has kind of a diamond pattern on it. So if we cut it right with the, use the lines to our advantage basically, and the triangle does fit right in there. So we're gonna cut it just before that line, because if we cut it after, it would kind of have little jagged edges and it would fray, I would imagine. So we're just gonna cut it like that and call it good. And then all you're gonna do is make it hug itself. So one side, just like that. And then you're gonna put a, it's a little tricky to glue because there's not really much substance to glue. So I put a bunch in there front and back, held it together with my fingers. One nice thing about this clear glue, or I guess it's white glue that dries clear, is it doesn't like to stick to fingers too much. So you can kind of use your fingers. And then as I was holding this, I stuck all the other pieces, the little shells and things, and that'll help it stick together as well. I also did end up just laying my pliers on it just to hold it down while it dried. There you go, a little wall decoration, a net that we caught some clams and things. Next up, we're gonna do this little rocking chair. This was a kind of a pain, but we got it in the end. That's all I can say. So there's gonna be a bunch of pieces, and you're gonna notice that these bigger C shapes, there's a flat end right there. So that's gonna be your seat. So make sure that goes to the bottom. And I just glued these as evenly as I could. And the biggest tip from the future, I can say, let this completely dry before you go to the next step, because it will want to bend on you when you want to put the netting on the back. And while that dries, I'm going to make the little holder here. It's kind of a cool chair. So what we're going to do is make a loop. The way I make loops is I leave it, I don't cut it to size before I make the loop. So I make the loop first and then cut it. It's just easier to manipulate. And then you're going to put it on the end of the kind of the hanger hook there. So you're going to open it up a little bit, put it through the hole, and then close it up. Once you got your ring on top, you're just going to stick it in the bottom. I did not add glue to mine. It was pretty solid. I was pretty confident that was not going to fall apart on me. So your little hanger's done. And I'm just being productive while my glue dries. So let's make the little S hook while we're at it. Pretty easy. This one I do cut to size because it's kind of hard to dictate where it's going to go. And I'm just going to use the same round-nosed pliers to make my circles, one going one way and one going the other. And that's how you make an S-hook. Ta-da! Alright, here we go, putting this netting on the back. Now it said to use a template to cut out my netting, and I looked through all my stuff and I couldn't find the template, the proper, I must have lost it somewhere, but that's okay. So we're going to do it this way. So what I did to tackle this is I just put glue everywhere and then I set it over the top. Then once I got it kind of to where I want it, I'm gonna clip it everywhere. And I did end up having to glue this several times in several stages. So I did the initial glue and clip, and then I kind of reformed it again after it dried a little bit, and then clipped it again. It was this is turning into quite the clothespin collage. It was a pain. It did not want to stick. Once I finally got it down, I did trim it down, and then I just went around and glued it again after I hung it. Just all those loose fray edges. It's a process. You just gotta be patient. And then we're gonna just put the little S hook on here. And then we're going to hook it into our base. Like I said, I did end up cleaning this up a little bit more, but you're getting the idea. It is a cute little chair, and I had an extra, they made me make two little yellow pillows, and I didn't know where the other one was, so I'm deciding it goes there. Ta-da! This one I thought was really cool. So what we're doing is making a telescope. So you're gonna have two black beads and a little skinnier black bead that goes into the end, and then there's a white bead. So you're going to stack those up and glue them. I did use the alcohol glue on this one. It stuck way better than the white glue will. And we're going to glue a little teeny tiny bead here, and I think that's where you focus it or something. I'm not sure. And then I thought I filmed this, but I guess I didn't. But basically, I cut a wire about 6 centimeters long, folded it in half and crimped it, and then I did another one that's 3 centimeters and then bent it out and glued it to the one that I folded in half. So you got a tripod. And then we're gonna do this little piece. Don't ask me what it's for. But it's two of these long skinny beads pushed together, and then a little teeny tiny seed bead stuck on top. what's nice about using the alcohol glue, it does dry pretty quick. And I do recommend it for anything with the metals and plastics. It glues a lot better than the white glue. So we're gonna put our little funky little piece that I'm sure is an important part of the telescope, but we're just gonna stick it down here. Kind of looks like a camera tripod. And then we're gonna put our actual telescope right on top. Once I got this about where I wanted it to go, I did prop it up a little bit. Clothespins, I use them a lot. And just let that dry until it's not gonna move anymore. And just like that. Ta-da! Super cute. Alright, we're gonna make this little life preserver. I didn't realize until the end that it was a clock. The little picture is a clock, but it's a life preserver. So you need a piece of string and four little red ribbons cut to size that it says on the instructions. And what I did is I just started by gluing the two ends together. So that's gonna be our starting point. And you're just gonna do top, bottom, left, right, side. So do each side one at a time. Once I got the top part relatively dry, now we're just gonna wrap it in this ribbon. So just make sure your gluing part is in the back so that it hides it. And we're just gonna put one side and then glue the other end. Pretty easy. It's just tedious because it won't let you do more than one at a time. So you just kind of have to do one, hold it there for a while. My clothespins don't fit around it, so I just have to hold it until it's pretty dry and then do the next and work your way all the way around. And then we're just gonna glue the little clock part, which honestly, while I was making it, I did not know it was a clock. Until now, I can see it. Like, ugh, cause it's so tiny. And there we go. Another piece to the puzzle. That's when I was like, hey, wait a minute, it goes like that. Now I was looking at the end pieces of the bedroom all finished, and I noticed that in the very back, there's instructions for a little pair of slippers. So it told me to use the yellow material. I thought it was too flimsy. I had a little bit of this fuzzy material left over, and I thought that made much better slippers in my opinion. And I think I have enough scraps that I can fit it on there. So let's cut out the patterns and we'll cut out the material. And it's pretty straightforward. Just make sure the pretty side of your material is facing up. And you're just gonna make this little half moon shape. It's gonna be the front end of each of your slippers. And I did use my clothespins to hold it while it was drying. You probably could hold it with your hands too. So I kind of bent it in half and then stuck it right on there. It fits pretty snug. Also in this picture, I noticed there's a little tiny rug that they just mention in one sentence. It says, cut it out. Okay, so we're gonna do that. And it can't be any simpler. You just use the pattern, cut the circle, you're done. And then you got a rug with some slippers on it. Ta-da! We did a lot of pieces in this one. So we did a whole bed, and we made clothes. When is the last time we've made little clothes? We made some wall decorations, a telescope, a rocking chair that actually does rock, a little bedside table, and another chair that's gonna go outside by the pool, basically. Not too shabby. This was a fun one. And the next one's going to be even more exciting because we're going to be building a lifeguard tower and a boat. Pretty exciting, so stay tuned and subscribe if you haven't already so you don't miss anything. And hey, it helps if you put a like if you like it and comment. You know, did you learn anything? So I'll see you next time and have a great day. Bye!